The next thing I wanted to do is kind of give a live demo of using the Automation Anywhere University website and the learning management dashboard that you have inside the university. And to do this, we're going to go through a short demonstration showing what's possible from the website point of view, and then selecting a learning trail, pushing that into our learning management system, and then interfacing inside the university, inside the learning management system. So to start, we're going to be here on our homepage for Automation Anywhere University. Note the URL is universityautomationanywhere.com. And with this, we can have access to all the different training types. We have learning trails, courses, instructor-led classes, technical webinars, everything we've went over previously with slides. Also, you can use this to start the process of doing certifications, and we'll have some slides towards the end that talk about the steps to take the advanced certification and what you'll need to do. So to start with, I want to enroll in a learning trail. I've already been registered with Automation Anywhere University. I have not yet logged in because it still has login showing up here at the top. But I'm interested in taking this bot developer learning trail. And all the different learning trails are listed in the learning trails page and color-coded. Blues are free, so there's the certification prep. And then the orange are pay, so the master certification. To do this prep course, you'll need to subscribe. From here, I could take the bot developer, which is a free course. And if I click on the tile, it'll bring me to an information page for that specific learning trail. So we'll let that load up. This gives us more details, how long the course takes. So this should take me about 2 hours and 30 minutes to move through the e-learning course. The format is e-learning, so it's not live instruction. It's just going through the e-learning courses. And the cost is free. And at the end, we get a badge, which is good things to do. We can come down and see the learning courses in the learning trail that encompass this learning trail. And some of these courses, like the Hello A2019 bot course, is included in several different learning trails. And you only have to take it once and you'll get credit for it. So I'm interested in this course. I want to enroll in the learning trail. And if I click and enroll, the website's going to move me to the login page. And this is where I can log in with my credentials. So type in your email and click next, and then type in your password. Have to make sure you choose the correct password, and then click login. And now this will take you through, this is a single sign-on login and password. So signing in through the university portal also signs you into APeople and the documentation site and the support site if it's part of your profile. So all those things are signed in at once. And now we can see we are inside the learning management system. So now the URL has changed to automationanywhere to litmos.com, and Litmos is our learning management system. And this is the learning path that I signed up for, which is the bot developer. I have already taken the getting started with building bots, so I've already got credit on this. And if I start this learning path, it'll take me to the next module that I want to do. So I don't want to start over with this module, so I can cancel out of this, and then I can start with the next part. So that gives me credit for 33%. That's one course out of three. And now I can start taking the next course, which is building resilient bots. When you're actually taking a course, it transitions into this presentation screen. And the presentation screen has different features. We have a drop-down menu, which shows if there's more than one piece of content, it'll list here on this side. You can also see if there's any documentation or files that you can download will show there. You can go to the next module if you want to, or you can exit it and remember your place. I'm going to go ahead and start this, and we'll see the presentation start. I'm going to quiet this, and I could turn on closed captions. So I can take this course silently and just read the closed captions as if I want to, and pay attention to the animations and take notes. If I want more details, I can come up here to the audio transcript and see an audio transcript of this specific slide of the e-learning one at a time. And this will refresh with each new slide portion of the e-learning. So there's a new slide. I can come back and look at the audio transcript for that slide. You can also see if this course has resources. And in resources, we have a step list for a lot of the bot building courses, Hello Bot, Building Resilient Bots, other courses like that. There is an actual PDF of the steps required to make this bot. So you can use this to help you create the bot and test the bot using Community Edition as your bot creator process. So make sure you check to see if there's any resources. You can also check for help, and it'll give you, it'll pause the video and tell you what all the different buttons on the screen can do. And when we exit out of help, we can go back and use this. This goes to the previous slide. This goes to the next slide. I'm two slides in, and I can actually click on this, and it'll come up with a menu with all the different slides. So if I've taken the course all the way through and I just want to review it again, I can scrub to a certain slide that I want to try at that point and skip through it. In order to get 100% on this, I have to have completed each one of the slides in this module. But now I'm busy. I want to continue. I can go ahead and exit, and it'll give me some credit for building the resilient bots. At least shows I've started it. I won't get any portion until I complete that whole slide deck. So these are 0 or 100% for each one of these here. And now I can see this as my progress. Here within the learning management system, I can click on the home button, and this is my dashboard of courses that I've enrolled in. And I can see my progress in all these different courses. So I'm partially done with the certification prep, I'm partially done with bot developer, and also getting started with RPA. If I look at the in progress courses, that will only show those courses that I have started. If I have a time delay, I can look at the overdue. I can also see the courses that I haven't started. So these are courses I haven't yet begun. And I can look at the courses that I've completed, and I can see I've completed the business analyst course prior to this. I can also add more courses to this from the content library. You can add courses externally, starting at the website, finding a learning trail and enrolling, or within the LMS, I can use the content library to add another course. So let's add a course that talks about Excel and see if we can find a course here. So there's one, Tips and Tricks Beginners. There's one for Citizen Developer. Those are learning paths. Here's a course, a singular course that automates tasks using a 2019 learning trail. So I can click on that. And then I've already completed it as part of my business analyst course, but I can add more content through the content library. You can look at either courses or learning paths, and learning paths can contain courses. It's a get used to learning paths being called learning paths inside Litmos. Outside, we call them learning trails. They're analogous. They're the same thing. I can look at my achievements. So I can see all these are all the courses I've completed. I also have certificates for each one of these. So I can look at my certificate itself, and I can download the little PDF document that tells me I've completed that. I've completed the business analyst learning path, and that should give me a badge. And then we could talk about live training. Live training shows you the trainings that's been registered. I've gone through the university side and assigned myself or set up myself for this Mastering Bots course. So these show me available time slices. If I go to the number registered, it shows me which time I actually have been registered for, the date it starts, who the instructors are, all those sort of things. I can click on the Learn More to get details specifically for this course. And with this Learn More page, there's places where I can add calendar events to my Outlook calendar so I don't forget to show up for this course. So there was a different download calendar links. And then we can exit out of this course side, and we're back to the actual course for the Mastering Bots instructor-led training. And I can get back to my home page to see all my current in-progress courses. Now let's go back to the learning trail, and let's talk about signing up for one of those instructor-led classes. So if I click on instructor-led classes, I see a list of upcoming classes and their dates. This is the course I signed up for, the 6th October Mastering Bots. So if I click on register, this is the place where you provided the details of the course, how long the course is, the maximum amount of seats the course is, how many learning objectives there are, and any prerequisite e-learning that needs to be done before that. Below that is the actual schedule for upcoming classes, and this will list the classes in by date and time and different time zones. and what language the primary course will be spoken in. So this is the English class I want to register for. I've actually already registered, but I'm going to walk through the process again. And this gives me the indication for it. I've already enrolled, so I don't have to worry about it, but you could, there'll usually be a place here to apply a coupon code if you have one for a course, and then also check out with your credit card number, CCV. If you're a subscription provider, you'll be able to add this by some other method. You have to be able to be logged in, and it'll recognize you and take you inside the LMS and have that course within your profile. Some other fine things with this is I can click on this to show the list view of courses if the tiles are too distracting and you like the list view. We also get a news course, and this gets updated periodically with new certification, new courses, new information of what you can do within AAU. Again, so in summary, we have the AAU Learning Management System. The litmos.com. That's the insides, and this is where you, the student, the participant, are interfacing with all of our learning content, our learning paths, and our courses. You can reflect your status here in your courses. You can look in to see more. So I've gotten credit for finishing building bots and for automating Excel user commands. I'm in the process of doing building bots. So even though these courses are also part of other learning paths, I get credit for them when I take them. So your actual learning paths go down. The more learning paths you complete, the you get achievements for those. Outside of this, so inside the learning management system, we can see home, we can add courses in the content library, we can look at the achievements we've made and have links to certificates, and we can look at any live training courses that we've been enrolled in. If we come back out to the university, the main site, universityautomationanywhere.com, this is where we have the homepage, where we talk about all the information. We have everything we could do by training, by learning trails, by courses, a list of the instructor-led classes, a list of technical webinars, an explanation of the subscription plans, and a link to all the courses for Enterprise A 2019 would be through here. If you're interested in doing your certification, there's a certification path. We'll go through the process of adding these certifications to your learning profile a little bit later. You can also see the badges that are available. If you want to take learning paths that are accessible through badges, come down to badges, and down here we'll talk when it gets done upgrading. Here's the different badges you can do, and they're aligned with different learning trails. So I'll have one for business analyst when they process that badge. It also is, this is a place where you can go and do your certifications. Again, we're going to follow this process later. If you wanted to engage with different communities, since you're signed in now to single sign-on, I have a My Profile and my logout, I can actually go to A People and be already logged in and engage with A People. I can go to Developer Portal and see the information that's there. I can look at the different blogs we have, go to the bot store, and see video libraries with helpful videos to help you with your process. So all these community resources are here. If you click on community resources itself, it actually brings up, I think, let's see, some titles for the different community places that we can go to. So we have A People, the Knowledge Series, the bot store, RPA Experts and A People again, the Learning Leaderboard. People have taken this course the most. Cynthia Scott is rocking it. And so all these are available, again, from the website, universityautomationanywhere.com. And for the things that you want to engage with in the training site for courses or learning trails, enrolling through this process will push you into, again, the learning management system portion of this, where you have your own personalized homepage of all your progress of all the courses you've taken. So this completes this demo. Remember, when you're done for the day, remember to sign out, because you don't want somebody else to take credit or somebody else to take courses for you. You want to take your own courses. We do want to make sure that everybody understands that universityautomationanywhere.com is the best place to get started. Started on the process, getting registered into the university itself, and gaining access to your internal learning homepage. Next, we'll be going through some slides that goes through how to get your certification attached to your learning profile and how to start the process of engaging with the certification process and having a good process with that.